Okay, the last extension I want to talk about today is the networks extension. We already played around with this a little bit in Unit 4, but I mentioned a little bit about how you could add calculations that would be much harder to calculate in NetLogo by putting them into extensions. And this model really exemplifies that, and that's why I want to talk about it. So this is another viral marketing model, In Unit 4, we call it diffusion information. This is taking it to the point of, I want to find who the best person to seed with a particular message is if I want that message to diffuse quickly through the system. And I have a budget, so I can determine how many people I can seed. I have a different types of networks, random and preferential attachment, like you saw what we saw before. But now I'm also going to have a seeding that's either random or based upon betweenness. And betweenness is exactly what I'm talking about when I'm saying that sometimes it's better to have a particular calculation be written in another language and then just have NetLogo use an extension to call it. And that's because betweenness is a really complex calculation. What betweenness is calculating is it's calculating how often a node appears on the shortest path between any of the other two nodes in the entire network, right? That involves comparing every node in the network, finding its shortest path to every other node in the network, and then figuring out what nodes are on those networks. As you might imagine, as we increase the size of our network, this calculation absolutely explodes. And in many cases, you don't want to put code like that directly into a NetLogo model, right? Instead, it's better to spend some time, develop a Java version of that or another language version of that particular code, and then have NetLogo simply call that version on the particular data set that you're looking at, right? And that's exactly what this model does. So what it does is you get your network like you normally do, right? We can lay it out a little bit. In this case, I have a preferential attachment network, and then you can watch the diffusion and you can track how quickly the diffusion happens through the entire network. And we can do things like change the budget, which essentially has the effect of seeding more individuals in the network, right? And see how quickly things go on. But we can also change between random and betweenness seeding. And random seeding is, as you might expect, a seeding strategy that seeds people randomly throughout the network, whereas betweenness tries to find individuals who have the highest level of betweenness centrality, that calculation where they sit on the most shortest paths between any two networks. And there's a number of arguments as to why betweenness centrality might be a very good way to seed, right? Because it's identifying people who really do seem to be on paths of information flowing through the entire network, right? So that's the model. Now let's look at how that's actually done. Okay, so here we are over in the code tab. And as we've discussed several times before, to pull in the extension, the first thing we do is do network, right? And then much like we did in, I'm gonna go down to create network first, right? Much like we did in the unit 4, right? We're gonna use the network extension to actually generate the networks, right? And here we're using it to generate both the random network and the preferential attachment network. Right? And so as you can see, for the random network, we're generating it for the turtles and the lynx, 500 nodes and a 0.004 probability of connecting any of the nodes. And the preferential attachment, just 500 nodes, right? So that we've seen before. We've seen using the network extension to generate networks. But what we haven't seen before is this use of the calculation. So what we're doing is we're saying, ask max n of budget. In other words, ask this budget turtles that maximize this reporter to set adopted to true and update their color. In other words, we're seeding them with the idea or the thing we're trying to spread based upon the ones that maximize between a centrality, right? And so that's a really cool way of using extensions, essentially, to put code into another place, some code that you're going to reuse frequently and then be able to call it within. And so a lot of the extensions that have been written for NetLogo essentially are doing that for you. They're taking common parts of code that used to have to write NetLogo code for, putting it into Java, putting it someplace else, and then allowing you to call it as a single command, making it easier for us to work with these models. So the network extension has a lot of other commands, right? Between the centrality is just one of the centrality measures in there. You could look at some of the other ones, like degree centrality, for instance, right? But they, I'll give you an example of how to do this. So that's it for the networks extension. And in the next talk, we're going to talk a little bit about the future of agent-based modeling.